through negotiation is intended to bring the report in November and to propose to council.
Okay, thank you. Right, second question is also from Councillor Phil Dilbrey, Councillor Julie McManus. Councillor Dilbrey, would you like to ask the question?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Proposals for the total refurbishment and traffic calming of Tower Road are being widely welcomed. In the meantime, can the council get the existing streetlights in that area working as, with winter approaching, students of Wirral Met College and the employees of the contact centre face a dark and dismal warm when they leave their training or work
process?
Thank you, Councillor Burgess, for answering to the question. A number of faults have been identified along Tower Road, Birkenhead, which primarily consists of loss of communication to the lantern's central management system, which unfortunately has resulted in a number of lights failing. The operations team is working towards a resolution, and I am confident that this matter will be resolved by the end of the month.
Thank you. And the third question is from Councillor Stuart Kelly and Councillor Tom Fletcher.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. It's a question to Cabinet Member for Children for Education. Can the Cabinet Member make a statement on the events in October last year at Stanley's special school? Does he think it's acceptable practice for a vulnerable child to be treated in the manner that's been reported, left outside in the cold without the enclosure? Speaking on social media, the child carers says that she has fought for 11 months for the truth and says that the local authority let him down so much. Can the cabinet member detail the help, support and guidance that was offered to the family in the wake of the incident and over the 11 months the matter has been covered up? Can he confirm that following the incident, the interim head of special educational needs at the council at that time conducted an investigation and issued a report? Will he undertake to publish that report and its recommendations? Can he further confirm in the past year the authority has issued warning letters to the governing body of Stanley Special School? Will he make public the terms of those letters? Will he ensure that all information is made public in the interests of openness and transparency for existing parents and potential parents who may futurely allocate to school and have a way to know that their children will be safe?
Thank you. Councillor Fletcher.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I would like to call into question the appropriateness of a question that could very much breach certain conditions of confidentiality in such a public forum, actually, because the school is currently going through some HR processes, and it's actually up to the governing body of the school as to how they wish to respond with that. Clearly, there was an incident at the school, and how the governing body responds is yet to be seen. I've been sending updates to members on Stanley School, and they've obviously been under the guise of remaining confidential, and I'll be sending out another one this week just to update you all. But as I've said, the response is down to the governing body and not myself. I do believe that we have, on a number of occasions, issued a warning to the school, and if you'd like a briefing on that, Councillor Kelly, then I'd be happy to sit down with you at some point and discuss that.
Thank you, Councillor. Right, we move on to the final question, and that's from Councillor Alan Rain to Councillor Pat Packard.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Amid the ongoing uncertainty over Brexit, and with just a fortnight to go now until we're allegedly going to leave the EU, can the Council be updated on Wirral's no-deal preparations? And in view of the urgency, why has the recently established elected members' Brexit Working Party not yet met? And in particular, what proactive advice and support is being offered to EU nationals from the other 27 EU member states who are part of our shared community here on Wirral.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Greg. Given the recent political developments and the recent likelihood of the UK leaving the EU on the 31st of October with no deal in place, it is, of course, timely to review our local Brexit planning. Given the lack of any clear guidance from government, Wirral's approach is focused on a comprehensive understanding of the potential implications for our residents and partners. We want to assure, of course, that they are as prepared as possible. Not an easy task given the lack of clarity nationally, as well as the unprecedented nature of the current events. Notwithstanding all that, over the last 18 months or so, Councillor Brown, we have been coordinating Wirral's approach to understanding Brexit and the local implications, of course, for our residents. This includes our Brexit planning group, made up of key council officers and partner agencies, to ensure we have a comprehensive overview as possible. Assistant Director Mark Campbell, as you know, is Wirral's lead officer for Brexit, working with our policy manager, Rosemary Boyman, to understand the implications and prepare appropriate plans. Mr. Mayor, a Wirral Brexit plan which analysed several issues based on no-deal scenario and suggested actions to mitigate them has been produced, and this approach is referenced, of course, within the Council's internal audit annual plan. As Councillor Green knows, this was most recently considered at Wirral's Audit and Risk Management Committee in July of this year, and a Brexit planning arrangements were discussed, of course, at party leaders' meeting on the 23rd of September, you will recall. We discussed that in detail. Just to finish, in relation to supporting EU residents, which Councillor Brown asked, we are working closely with local partners and across the Liverpool City region to raise awareness of legal rights and how residents can get information and support to access the EU settlement scheme. Wirral Change, a great organisation, is a key agency who have been commissioned by government to produce advice and information for residents, and to date we've assisted over 900 people. Individual group leaders were asked to nominate Councillor Brown, a representative, because you were asked that for the last question, a representative from their group to work with the Brexit planning group, and the initial meeting of this group is currently being arranged. But it's important group leaders give us a name for that group. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, thank you, Councillor. Right. There'll be no further questions. We'll now move on to item 8, and that's vacancies. Members are asked to receive nominations in accordance with Standing Order 25.6 in respect of any proposed changes in the membership of committees and to approve nominations for appointments to outside organisations. A number of changes have been notified and are detailed on the summons and supplementary agenda pack. We've also been notified by we have a vacancy on the Merseyside Police and Crime Panel. Councillor Jill Wood is standing down, and the group will advise the name of replacement later. Okay? And if there's no objection, can we agree to the nomination by assent? Thank you. Right, item 9, matters requiring approval or consideration by the Council. Council, if we now turn to item 9 on pages 83 to 674 of the Council summons, which includes reports and recommendations requiring approval or consideration by the Council. The first one is 9A, Statement of Accounts 2018-19 for Wirral Council Merseyside Pension Fund, 83 to 386. That's the Merseyside Pension Fund one has been withdrawn. Is that correct?
Yes.
That's right. Okay, yeah, that has been withdrawn, so apologies. Wrongly put in. Okay. Move on to 9B, Revenue and Capital Combined Monitoring 2019-20 7402. This is a referral from the Cabinet meeting held on the 2nd of September 2019. And I call on Councillor Jeanette Williamson to move the recommendation detailed on the agenda. And I call on Councillor Pat Hackett to second. Right, Councillor Williamson, you have now 5 minutes to speak to your motion. Okay. Are there any speakers? No. Okay, seconder, Councillor Hackett, you have 3 minutes to speak to the motion.
It's great, isn't it?
Okay. Right, Councillor Williamson, you now have the right to reply. So now can we have electronic voting on Niall? Okay. Everyone on the... Okay, all had a chance. Closing the vote. Yes. Okay.